everyone. Welcome back to my channel. And welcome to another episode of Careers in Math, Get to Know the Professional series, where I feature various professional workings in insurance, finance, technology, healthcare, and more for job related to math, technology, and data. So today, I'm very excited to introduce you to another guest and a good friend of mine from the University of Waterloo and Wilfrid Laurier University, double degree, math and business. So he's currently working as an accountant, and he actually studied actuarial science before decided to switch career into accounting path. So let's hear Marco's story, and also stay tuned until the end where I will talk about a little bit differences and similarities between actuary and accountant. So now let's get started. Hi Marco, can you tell us a little bit about yourself?
All right, so I'm Marco, and I'm an accountant. I currently work as in the capacity of a director and tax advisor group in a large Canadian multinational life insurance company. I have been with the company for the past 6 years, working in central accounting as well. So all relevant to kind of the accounting experience. But before that, I also had some non-accounting experience in corporate finance, operation, and even actuarial type work.
Thanks, Marco. So what led you to pursue the accounting path?
Quite honestly, before joining, doing university, I didn't know what I wanted to do. And fortunately, I was doing the math and business double degree program at University of Waterloo, which allowed me to do actuarial science and accounting at the same time. So I've always had the choice to go different ways. When I started out, after I graduated, I started with actuarial science, and I also did actuarial science when I was doing co-op. So I knew what actuarial science was about, but after about a year within my actuarial full-time, I was thinking it was a bit too much about model maintenance and operations and too much on grinding the numbers as opposed to thinking about what those really mean on the business side of things and providing like more significant inputs to the business decisions. So I wanted to see if getting into accounting path would give me more of those kind of exposure. So I decided to go back and kind of get my CPA designation. And at the time, the easiest way I figured was to go back to school, get another master's degree with co-op experience. So I did. And fortunately, upon graduation, I was able to join a company I'm with their CPA rotational program. So far how I got into accounting.
Can you tell us about the various accounting designations and how to achieve them?
There were various accounting designations, and there still have some different certifications out there. The most prominent ones you might have heard in the past were the CA, which is the Chartered Accountants, the CMA, Certified General Management Accountants, and CGA, Certified General Accountants. But they are all mostly consolidated into the CPA right now, which is the Chartered Professional Accountants. And that was the goal of that was to go in line with the CPA designation that is recognized worldwide. Well, there's a US CPA, and then I in the UK, they're probably called differently, but probably in the Australia, they also call it CPA. So it's to get in line with the kind of international designation kind of thing. But I was more so focused on the CA path before the consolidation. So I would say I know more on that, but I don't know too much about the qualification standards for the CMA and CGA. I just knew that they also had exams and had some practical experience requirement, but by far CA would have been the most comprehensive one. And the goal was to kind of like make sure everyone is designated and certified and under the same standard. So to become a CPA now, which is similar to the CA path in the past, you'll have to first make sure you get all the qualified required courses in your undergrad studies. That would involve like finance, accounting, economics. So basically you need to know how the business world functions. And then after that, you'll have to go through the PEP, the Professional Education Program. And along with that, it's a series of modules and a final exam, which we'll call the CFE. It used to be called the UFE, but now it's called CFE, the Common Final Exam. And there's also the practical experience component, which is about 3 years. So all in all, after you finish undergrad studies, you can spend about 3 years of time to go through all the PEP courses, modules and exams, at the same time get your practical experience requirement and finish your CPA designation.
To work in the accounting field or to practice, do we need to have those designations?
Obviously you don't, if you, depending on what you want to do. It's but a lot of times in the corporate finance world, CPAs are almost becoming a must, I would say, because the CPA trainings are typically rigorous enough for people to give it a sufficient amount of recognition. So if you really want to have a good career path, it's almost a must that you should have your CPA in corporate finance world. Obviously, it's not necessary if you are going to like, there are different routes. For example, MBA, you can go into like the planning side of things. So you don't need to be a CPA. There could be more on the budgeting side of things. CPAs would be more so on the reporting side of things. But then most of the time, people, executives in the corporate finance world tend to have CPAs. It's more likely. But there are also other career paths where if you want to just be a bookkeeper, there's also a certification called CPB, so the Certified Professional Bookkeeper. I'm not too familiar with that, to be honest, but I would say that CPA has a more comprehensive training and more recognized, so you get more employment opportunities and also more variety as well with getting CPA. But in terms of qualified, I would refer you to the CPA Ontario or CPA Canada website just to understand more on the details.
What does an accountant do anyways? Can you describe a little bit about your work and responsibilities or typical day and week?
Any day could be different, but typical responsibilities for an accountant, I'll just say for my own example, I was in the central accounting department where I get involved with management accounting, financial reporting, and a little bit of planning analysis. So I'd say the majority of the responsibilities revolve around making sure all the account information is aggregated, is accurate. So that would be like doing a lot of controls and preparing financial statements during quarter ends, performing variance analysis to make sure all the numbers appearing on them are reasonable, and making sure the accounting standards are followed when we prepare those financial statements. So these types of work typically are more rigorously checked during quarter ends and year ends as we publish financial statements on. And so we would be under the scrutiny of internal controls as well as external auditors. A more detailed example with the type of work that is being done as to what I just described could be, for example, there could be some changes in the intangible asset line, and from the previous quarter to current quarter, there could be a big change. We would have to understand what drove that change and is it reasonable, or could there be mistakes with what we're reporting? And those kind of supports will go to the auditors, so to make sure, you know, nothing is materially misstated, everything is accurately presented. And then off quarter ends, we could have various process improvement projects or handling new transactions, and even monitoring changes to accounting standards. For example, there's some could be changes to IFRS 9, IFRS 15, 16, and 17, and we would need to know what they are about and whether or not they are making impacts to how we report things. So that's a typical kind of accounting type of work. With tax, it's a little bit different. There's also the compliance side of things and the advisory side. With compliance, it's a little similar to reporting where, you know, you're doing the routine type of work, and on a quarterly basis, you need to do tax provisioning. And that is essentially calculating the amount of tax, income tax you are owing CRA for your company. And it also includes filing annual tax returns or various other information returns. With advisory, things are a little bit more interesting in the sense that you would be looking at specific transactions, understanding tax implications, and potentially providing solutions to minimize tax impacts or optimize tax benefits. So for me, I recently switched from the compliance team to the advisor team. And in compliance, you deal more with routine processes, as I said, but there are also times where you have to look at transactions and tax filing positions and perform technical analysis. Now, advisory could be a bit more than that in the sense that you deal with a more variety of transactions because you mainly deal with transactions. You don't really go with the routine processes. So it's more like project management in a sense, because you work with people from different departments and understand what they're talking about. And since you are typically involved as a transaction that's being planned or prepared, as opposed to after all transactions are already done, you have the opportunity or to provide input to shape or structure the transaction. Whereas for compliance, it's typically after the fact, and you can only analyze what are the correct numbers to be reported. So the advisor process require a bit more of a comprehensive technical analysis to identify ways to optimize your transaction. It is more exciting, and you are more involved in the actual business decision and have a chance to provide significant value. But at the same time, it's very challenging.
In your opinion, what makes a good accountant?
This question is interesting in the sense that I actually don't think there are traits that would particularly make good accountants that wouldn't make a good employee or, you know, person with responsibilities. It's I think most of the successful executives out there have very common shared a common characteristics. So I'd say, if anything, what's more important to accountants would be the attention to detail. But at the same time, you can't lose sight of the bigger picture. Once you have the basic financial knowledge, and which we'll learn along the way of becoming a qualified CPA, it's all about how much you learn about the particular business or industry you're in, applying your technical knowledge to solve the specific problems, utilizing various soft skills along the way. Well, this is not to say that technical knowledge is unimportant, but instead, it's technical knowledge is very important, but it's only the starting point for you. And soft skills are the ones that solve the problems effectively and creatively. Just as a reference, if you search online, typically you'll find that what a good accountant would be is they're highly organized. They have good time management. They are good problem solvers, and they're adaptable, have good communication, quick learner, and trustworthy and reliable. Now, if you think a little bit more about it, every profession needs it. For all of those who work in an office environment, or even those not working in an office environment, those are usually the ones that you kind of like, you just need to have the qualities you need to have to successfully deliver, right? Whatever you need to do. But I would say, if anything, out of those that are more specific or particular for accountants, it would be being reliable, being adaptable, because in accountant, the CPA offers a variety of opportunities, right? It's a general set of training, but at the same time, it allows you to get into different types of roles. You can supplement it with CFA, you know, going to the investment and asset management side. You can supplement it with tax knowledge, so I would be an example to go on the tax side of things. But all of those are different specializations and a CPA is kind of like the basic training that can help you go further with those. Again, those are all typical good traits for any profession, but it's good to be adaptable and be reliable.
So for those who are interested in becoming an accountant, do you have any tips or advice for them?
If you are still in high school and university, definitely study hard on the required subjects, but don't just study hard, right? It's what's more important than acquiring the basic technical knowledge is to really know what you're good at. Know yourself, know what you're interested in, know what you're good at, and know how businesses work, and the types of roles out there along with their requirements. At the end of the day, employment is you providing the necessary skill sets that employers want, and solve problems accordingly. So try to figure out what accountants do, you know, how businesses function, how the business world functions, how different industries are like, and attend different extracurricular activities. Ask people you know, or just people on LinkedIn for coffee chats to learn more about what they do and tips. Make sure you're well-informed before committing yourself to a long career. And that will be the same for every other profession.
So what do you guys think about being an accountant or the accounting career path? Let's talk a little bit about the differences or similarities between being an accountant and being an actuary. So I would say in terms of education, you can see that both Marco and I both study math and business, and it opened enough of the possibilities for us to choose either path. Of course, if we know that we wanted to become an actuary and accountant, then we would take more courses back in university focusing on those. So, and then in order to become qualified, we do have to go through different education system. So for an accountant, so as Marco say, having CPA is very beneficial, and same as like to become an actuary in Canada, like having either an associate or a fellow with the society actuaries or with the casualty actuary society would be very useful in for the job, and especially if you want to move up higher in moving up in the company later on. About the skill set, I do agree that in order to excel or being good in our job, and especially if you want to move up to leadership level, like the soft skills, including being adaptable, being flexible, problem solving, analytical skill, communication skill, like all those areas are very important. So at the end of the day, what you really want to look into this is like, what kind of business problems that you are solving as an actuary versus an accountant. So I would say for an actuary, what we do is like we're trying to predict the impact of the adverse event in the future. So we're using statistic or like actuarial science applications in order to do that. But and therefore an accountant, we're really looking at like reported on the impact of on the financial, what actually already happened. Although like if you go for management accountant, so you maybe do like more budget and those kind of work, but it's not so much about like predicting future events or unlikely adverse event like an actuaries. So accountant and actuary do work together in a company, and especially if you work in a life insurance company, having knowledge of a little bit about actuarial knowledge and accounting knowledge is very beneficial. Try to research and to see like what kind of industry that you would like to work in, or the business problems that you want to solve, and do more research and planning, career planning in that time to see like what kind of career path that you are more interested in. At the end of the day, you need to have the skill sets in order to provide a solution to the problems that the employers are looking for, and that is the same for any of the professional job as Marco mentioned. So yes, I'm hoping that this video is helpful for you. And both career options are great potential for people who are interested in career related to math and numbers. So definitely do your research, connect with people to understand more about the work and like how much effort in order to pursue each career path. Let me know if you have any questions and what do you think about being an accountant versus being an actuary. And I hope you have another productive week ahead, and see you in the next week episode.